wens jullie gewoon heel veel plezier vanavond met Joey, met Alex en met Vanessa Peters. Graag een warm keerpunt welkom.
Hey, yo.
Dank u wel. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming tonight. This first song is called Good News. I've been singing at the top of my lungs, and nothing seems to be getting through. I guess these are songs you've already been sung. And the girls say, don't get lost in the job, it's just a way to make ends meet. Just keep staring at your feet. There's good news in the paper today. This war keeps driving on, and they're sending more sailors out to sea to get sucked in by the sun. Don't seem to do any good. I guess they're all a whole lot stronger than me. They just sail on home like they should. And I've never been much good at this job, but it's the only place that I call. This war keeps dragging on, and they're sending more sailors out to sea to get sucked in by a storm. She's a pretty one waiting in your bed. I could have made you the king of the sea, but I watched as you turned that ship around. You chose her instead of me. There's good news in the paper today. This war to sea to get sucked in by a storm, to get sucked in by a storm, they get sucked in by a storm. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here tonight. My name is Vanessa Peters. I'm from Texas. This is Joe Reyes. He's also a fellow Texan. This is Alex Akela, citizen of the world. It's true. Alex is everywhere all the time.
True.
He was here just last month, I think, in fact. So, this is a song off of my last record, and it's about the time in my life when I moved to Austin to try to make it in the singer-songwriter scene. Sort of talks about the difficulties of being one of a million people that are all trying to do the same thing. And it's called Austin, I Made a Mess. Well, I had a heart full of good intent, a sweet little house paid a decent rent, but I shouted and shouted and no one heard. I tried to carve out my own little place. I followed the rules till I was blue in the face. But someone else always had the last word. But you know that you can't blame me for that, 'cause I know I'm not the first to make that mistake. And you never made me a promise, but you seem so full of promises. Was I a fool to think there's one in there for me? And if a tree falls and no one hears, well, it's like that with all. With all of these years, no one knows what happened, so maybe watching a football game on TV, and in English we have a phrase called a Hail Mary, which in football is at the end of the game when your team's about to lose, the quarterback will put a receiver all the way at the end of the field, and he'll throw the ball as far as he can in hope that they can score in the last couple of seconds of the game. And it's one of those plays that usually doesn't work, but if it does work, you're the hero and everybody loves you. And if it fails, then everybody says, "Why did you do that stupid thing?" And This is a song sort of about a moment like that in my own life, and it's called Co-Pilot. Tried to hold my gaze, but I just looked away. Watched a Hail Mary pass on the screen. It's the first day of the new year. It's the perfect day to finally say what I mean. And man, that quarterback's off to a great start. He's a hero now, he's won the nation's heart. And I wish I had a throwing arm, I wish I had better aim. I wish I could convince you to stay in the game. But Hail Mary, Mother of God, I'm hitting the road. Could you take notes? So I turn off my brain, I turn off my heart, I turned off the porch light, I turned off the stars, I packed a suitcase of regret to take with me. I closed the front door, threw it into the back seat. I keep my eye on them in the rear view. They're always there to see me through. But Hail Mary, Mother of God, I'm hitting the road. Could you drive. I'm kinda lucky I made it home alive. Not sure how much of this that I've got left, but I know that I won't do it by myself. So anyone really kind of interesting story. A friend of mine who's quite a bit older than me, her mother passed away a couple of years ago, and she was a child of the Depression and of both World Wars, actually. So she was always very aware of making sure she had enough of everything. You know, she never wasted anything, saved everything. And by the time she died, she also had a little bit of dementia, and she didn't remember things very well. So, like, when she went to the grocery store, she would always get a roll of aluminum foil because she didn't remember if she had it at home. And when she died and they cleaned out her kitchen, she had like 70 rolls of aluminum foil stashed all over the kitchen. So you can imagine what it was like to clean out her house whenever they had to do that. And one of the things, they found a million things in the attic, and one of them was a very large box, like for a man's suit, in the corner, and it had a little piece of tape on it that said "string too short to use." And they opened it up, and it was full of little tiny pieces of string that she had saved from like sewing projects or when she sewed on a button or something, and she was afraid to throw them away. So she had this giant box of string that never got put to any use because it was too short. So I thought that was kind of a cool phrase, "string too short to use." So I took it and put it to some use finally. So,
yeah. Here we go.
String too short to use, I can't bind me to you. I've studied all the knots in my heart. You keep on falling through, and I can't tie it tightly. I cannot get a grip. String too short to use.
Just a wild B minor.
Mm-hmm. Wanna play a little harmonica?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Okay.
What's that?
Gone?
Oh, okay. What kind of key?
As this one's in C, yeah. Song written about the small town in Italy that I used to live in and have been visiting for about 10 years. It's kind of my second home. And yeah, it's a song about Castiglione Fiorentino and it's called Gone.
Hit me that I was
we're going to give each of you instruments and you can play.
Absolutely.
All over the
shadows.
From the back, from the front.
Play your own show.
Awesome.
We saw a woman in Nijmegen yesterday. You know, there's always the people playing like accordion on the street or something. And all she had was a tambourine.
Yeah.
It was the strangest thing. She just stood there.
She needs to work on that.
She looked so confused, like why nobody would stop and give her money, but all she was doing was just, it was very, and then later we saw another guy with an accordion and a saxophone, and we thought, maybe we should tell them about each other, they could make a trio, and then they could be really good, but
yeah,
it was a little bit strange, so. All right.
Didn't feel like producing
What, you like being a producer here?
Yeah. Like,
it was a long walk back to the other corner to try to get the other lady.
It was gonna, and our 10% would have been very little.
Yeah, that's true. Our booking fee would have been very small. Wasn't worth it. Maybe next time. Alright, this is another song off of the last record, and it's called The Grammar of a Sinking Ship. So unfair for you, and it's so unfair of me to be swept up and forth. I'm a lot more saw than sea, and I am more gone than going. I'm more past than I am present. I left and I'm leaving. The tense makes a little difference, 'cause it's the meaning. Snow, I don't know, it's pretty cold outside.
It did get cold, yeah.
It's not quite snow cold yet.
It's nice though. It's 90 degrees in San Antonio.
Yeah, our friends back home are turning on the air conditioning.
Yeah, it's getting hot.
At home, seriously. It's about 32 degrees Celsius, I think, today.
Yeah,
it's pretty hot.
It's gonna be warm.
It's gonna be a hot one. Yeah. Alright, I'll do medals.
Okay, cool.
Alrighty. Well, this is a song about if you've ever known anybody that had to win, the person that always has to be right in every argument, in every conversation. This is a song about people like that.
I mean, I'm never that way, right? Sure, you're never that way. You actually are never that way. You're way too agreeable. You need to be a little angrier.
Well, that's okay. Well, I don't want to try to see if we
can
get Alex angry.
That's true. So, it's a song called Metals. Let's always spend such a contest with you. The score is never final till you say we're through. And I've built you a pair of wings, and onward you flew. Now every so often I get a small bit of news, but I'm tired of chasing medals, and I'll never run as fast as you backpedal. In a few years after the games have passed, you sit there watching your gold, and I'm not so sure the silver and bronze aren't just for the audience at home, and I resign myself to the distance, the million laps it would take to reach where you sit. The salt in my eyes and my weak jello heart, and I wonder if it's even worth it. If it's even worth it. Some dreams that you'll never capture, they loom over your head and they block out the sun. You stare at them enraptured, and that's how you fell out of love with me and in love with higher stature. Your friend shook their heads and said, her, 'cause she's tired of chasing medals, and she'll never run as fast as you backpedal. In a few years after the games have passed, you sit there watching your gold, and I'm not so sure the silver and bronze aren't just for the audience at home. Resign myself to distance, a million laps it would take to reach where you sit. Salt in my eyes and a weak jello heart, and I wonder if it's even worth it. If it's even worth it. Chasing medals, and I'll never run as fast as you backpedal. In a few years after the games have passed, you sit there watching your gold. Well, I'm not so sure the silver and bronze aren't just for the audience at home. And I resign myself to the distance, a million laps it would take to reach where you sit. The salt in my eyes and my weak jello heart, and I wonder. much?
Yeah.
Well, we'll do a few more and then take a little break so everybody can run around and act crazy. And then come back here and be so calm and peaceful. This is another calm and peaceful song, though. This song is actually the title track to my last record. It's a song called Keep Your Chin Up. And it was inspired by a book that I don't know if it was very popular over here, but it's called Wicked. And it's a story, it's the Wizard of Oz story told from the point of view of the Wicked Witch of the West. And it's a very interesting book. It's kind of about not judging people on their appearances and
I thought she was hot.
Yeah, she was hot. She was bright green.
Yeah.
Well,
I thought she was
gay. And it's a story about sort of not giving up on things, about maintaining hope. So. Well, there are no pills left to swallow. The bitterest part's gone down. No breadcrumb left to follow, 'cause the storm's blown through town. I'm sifting through these postcards, and I've a lot of sad memories trapped in bubbles. That's what's in my head. So sweetheart, keep your chin up. The good witch is still around. Down. I could not save us from it. The sky was burned and browned. It was curling at the edges as the fire destroyed it all. And all that kept us on the ledge, dear, was the memory of the fall. So let them keep your chin up and take.
right.
But she's happy. Alex let me borrow his guitar for this tour, which was so nice. Because it has gotten really difficult to fly with guitars. They torture you with cattle prods if you try to bring your guitar on board now. Ow. So.
What happened to Joe?
It did.
He had to suffer to bring his guitar. So.
He has to just be sort of sly. You just gotta, I don't know, kind of walk in like this.
Yeah. Hi, how are you? Hi, good. How are you? Yeah. Fine, thanks. I could. Okay.
That's it, yeah. But you can kind of hide it behind you.
It's true. There's actually a guy that has is it Chris Smithers? Is that who?
Yeah.
It is?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Chris, yeah.
That has a website online where he talks about
how to stick them on there.
There's a way to get your guitar on board. Oh. There's all these steps you have to follow about, like, you check in early and
there's a few things, yeah.
He tells, like, you can look and see the different people at the check-in counter, like, which one is probably going to let you bring your guitar. And, it's true. You have to learn which planes the Airbuses or the Boeings and what size they are and how long they're. It's a
science.
You think this is an easy job? This is not an easy job.
This part is fun.
This part is easy.
Yeah, this part.
Getting your guitar on the plane is really hard, though.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
All right, we'll do this and then we'll take a break. This is the title track to my last record, and it is called Little Films. That those years were made of. Thanks very much. We'll take a small break and then come back for another set. So please stick around. Hello again. Thank you for all your help collecting coasters, everybody. I got a bunch more, yeah.
It was a
hunt,
I didn't realize.
I didn't either. So this next song is another one off of my last record, and it's funny because it came up today at dinner when I was at Jan and Maria's house. We were talking about arguing with your teenage daughter and how a lot of conversations end with, because I said so. And this song was actually inspired by a conversation I used to have with my stepfather, who would, anytime I would say, well, why can't I do it? You get to do it. And he would say, because you should do as I say and not as I do, which would always frustrate me quite a lot. And so this song is actually about Icarus, who steals his father's wings to fly too close to the sun. And it's a good example of a time that maybe he should have listened to his father. So it's called Just Down. Well, how many times do I have to tell you? Many people, it's actually a Tim Hardin song, and Rod Stewart did a version of it, and so did Wilson Phillips. I don't even know if Wilson Phillips was ever known here, but he did an awesome 80s pop version of this song. So it's a good one. It's called Reason to Believe, if you want to sing along.
Oh yeah, see you
now. Well, if I listened long enough to you, I'd find a way to believe it's all. still I look to find a reason to believe. Still I look to find a reason to believe. My record Little Films, and it's a very cinematically themed album, and this song is called Such Good Actors. I used to be in a very bad habit of writing songs while I was driving. Ian Moore does that too. That makes me feel better.
He said he had he'd gone fishing, and he was the idea came to him. Well, he was late for a gig, so he was in his waders.
In his fishing outfit,
riding it on the steering wheel, and then he got pulled over, and the cop was like, "What are you doing?" He's like,
"I'm fishing and
writing a song
at the same time."
It was a very expensive ticket. So you did this too?
Yeah, I used to do this a lot when I toured. Once I started touring with the band, I didn't do it as much. But when I was alone, especially when you're touring in America and you're driving 10 hours at a time, and you're still not there yet. You start to do all kinds of crazy things to pass the time, including writing songs.
You are pretty good with the GPS and driving.
Yeah, I'm a very good multitasker, it's true.
I haven't felt frightened at all.
Thank you.
I feel like I'm in good hands.
I know you guys in Europe think that we're crazy because we talk on our cell phones and do all these things. But, I feel like it's sharpening my brain because I'm able to concentrate on any number of things at one time, but maybe not. But anyway, maybe. I wrote this song at 2 o'clock in the morning one night when I was on my way home from a gig, and I was kind of trying to stay awake, honestly. And it's called Such Good Actors. So easy to find, and 2006, so.
Oh, wow.
That's not that back catalog, but.
Yeah, but.
This place has been here for 275 years.
Yeah,
is that right? No. Joe and I were looking at that earlier and we were like, wow, 250 years. That's older than our country, isn't it?
Pretty much, yeah, this club.
I think so. They've
been playing music here for a while.
Pretty awesome.
Yeah, yeah. Pretty I feel awesome. Honored to be here.
Yeah.
It's got a long tradition.
So, this is kind of a fun getaway song, and it's called Bonnie and Clyde.
Bag and
Well, I wrote this song a couple of years ago. I was back when I was living in Italy, and I was in a town called Padua, and that's where the Basilica of St. Anthony is. Yeah.
That was my mom's favorite saint.
Really? Well, what's interesting about this saint is apparently St. Anthony, there's two St. Anthonys, because they're saints of two different things, but this one is the saint of lost things, or people, or kind of open to interpretation, I guess. But there's a really cool shrine inside the basilica where people have left notes to St. Anthony thanking him for returning something or somebody that was lost to them. There were some very touching stories with people that had been separated from their children or their loved ones, and then they were reunited, and so they would take pictures of themselves and put them up with a letter, and it was very, very sweet, actually. And so this song is called St. Anthony. It's just about thinking about things that you've lost and knowing they're sort of, you know, when you lose something and you know it's right there and you can't quite put your finger on it, it's very frustrating. Well, sometimes that happens more in a spiritual or emotional sense, and that's kind of what this song was about. So it's called St. Anthony.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Awesome.
You can keep that little
guitar. Alex plays a little guitar. That's the mandolin joke. I play a little guitar. I can do it with ukulele too. It's also a ukulele joke.
Yeah. That's something you could probably bring on board with no problems.
Oh, you know what? Next time.
Start touring with the ukulele.
Next tour. Yeah. I'll just bring something very small.
Very small guitars.
I love the little. They're kind of fun. All right.
This is a song by a band that I don't even know if they were ever known over here, but they're called the Gem Blossoms. And this is, oh, thank you so much. I tend to just go through that water like it's free. It's better than going through lots of beer, right?
Yeah. Lots of beer. I didn't see you as a beer drinker for whatever reason.
I'm not really a big beer drinker.
Yeah.
Whiskey, right?
Ah, you look like a whiskey.
This song is called Hey Jealousy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I like that song.
That's good.
It's like a mid-90s kind of
hit. It was
How did they do that in the middle of all that Nirvana
I don't know.
Music? I don't know, it was pretty poppy.
Well, it definitely didn't have a mandolin in the original, that's for sure.
Yeah, I like it though. That's our unplugged
It's
version.
Better with the mandolin thing.
Yeah, absolutely.
They should do an unplugged version of it for sure. Well, this song is my anthem for Holland. This is a song I wrote, actually, by now, a long time ago. I wrote it after my very first tour here. It was with Alex, I guess 3 or 4 years ago now. And we went everywhere by bus and by train, and had a very, very large backpack and a rolling suitcase and a guitar. So I had a little bit too much stuff to be walking everywhere. But I came in May because I was told it would be absolutely beautiful. I think you told me that. And I'm just kidding. And it rained every day for 2 weeks straight. And I showed up to all of my gigs with, you know, like very wet hair and very pathetic looking. I left a pair of shoes at one of my gigs because they were wet and I took them off, and then we were running to catch the train and I was running in my flip-flops going, why is this so uncomfortable? Ah, my shoes are back.
Oh my God. Yeah,
it was just a crazy, crazy tour. But the very last day, the sun was shining finally, and I was in Amsterdam and I was so excited, and so I went for a little walk. And then I sat down at a cafe by one of the canals to have a little cup of tea, and I got comfortable and got ready to write in my journal, and then out of nowhere this big black cloud came and landed over my cafe and then started to pour down rain, and I said fine. So I went inside and I got trapped inside for like an hour because it was raining too hard for me to leave, and I wrote this song that's called Drowning in Amsterdam. On my way.
was that one moment. Okay.
See, I didn't mind the rain so very much after all.
The rain lets me play a bunch of notes.
That's right.
I guess it's raining notes. I guess that's what it is, right?
Rain,
that's what I'll say it is. Like the whatever I was doing. I don't know.
You were mimicking a thunderstorm.
Okay, good. Yeah, that's perfect. Okay, rather than overplaying or whatever, whatever someone else might call that. Jeez. No, that's cool.
All right. Well, this song is called "Coming to Meet Me." It's a little bit about my fear of flying, and a little bit about when I was missing my hometown. We have the, you know, Mobil, the gas company that doesn't exist anymore. Did you guys ever have Mobil over here? Yeah, now ExxonMobil. So there's the red horse that was the symbol, the Pegasus horse. Well, that actually comes from an oil company that was based in Texas called the Magnolia Oil Company. And Pegasus was their symbol, and then Mobil bought Magnolia. And there's a building in downtown Dallas that has the big Pegasus horse. It has the original one on top. And it's really nice. It's part of the skyline that you can see when you're driving through downtown. You can sometimes see this giant red glowing horse. It sounds kind of strange maybe, but it's actually quite pretty.
Floating
in the sky, yeah. And I used to always look for it when I was flying in from being gone for a long time when we would come over Dallas. I would sort of look and try to find it. And it's gotten harder as the years go by because the buildings keep getting taller and taller. That used to be the tallest building in Dallas, and now it's not very tall at all. So this is a song kind of about coming home and wondering what would be waiting there and looking for my little horse. So it's called "Coming to Meet Me." Not the wings of Pegasus that carry me tonight across a deep, dark sea. So I cannot sit back, I cannot relax, enjoy the flight.
To meet me, and it's true.
have changed at all, but I still remember when I was a kid. Swoop down on Pegasus to where I hid. Over the freeway, I see a pair of lights. I think I recognize. Could that be you coming to meet me? Sunday, we're like, no, like, Joe, oh, slow down, it's Saturday.
Whoops, I'm in no hurry, but, and then it's daylight savings time tonight, right?
So yeah,
we'll be back on, we've all lost 2 hours now, really.
Yeah, we were saying it's very unfortunate, because we had to do daylight savings time last week, or two weeks ago.
Yeah.
So we've been living on one schedule for 2 weeks, and now we're going to have to change again.
Yeah, so what we have to do is come back next fall.
We're going to come back in October, and then we're going to get extra hours.
2 extra hours back. My life. Yeah, that would be good. If that actually worked, it'd be awesome.
That'd be great.
And just, you can't turn back the clock, right? No. Not yet.
It's actually very bad planning because I got married 2 weeks ago. And
congratulations.
Thank you. When we picked the day, we didn't know it was daylight savings time. And then we also booked our flight to go on our honeymoon, and our flight departed at like 6 a.m. And it wasn't until like February that we realized, oh my goodness, the party's going to go on and on, and then we're going to lose an hour of sleep, and then we have to get up at like 3 a.m. to go to the airport, which is really 2 a.m. or something. Oh, it's very bad. Don't recommend it.
That was rough, yeah. I don't know. I had a rough week at South by Southwest, but you got married. That trumps everything.
That's true.
To me, it's like,
I win. This is a song about Penelope, from Penelope and Odysseus, and it's called The Next Big Bang. Try hard not to complain about the weather or anything else here, 'cause things have pretty much stayed the same since the call came and you headed on your odyssey, looking to make a name. And most days I just hold my breath. you to Jaap and Willem for booking the show, and for Case for doing a fantastic job on sound, and for being a very dedicated sound person. Thank you.
Sounds great.
It's nice to find somebody that cares about doing good sound.
Absolutely.
And it's very unusual.
That cares about what they're supposed to do. Absolutely. I like those people.
If you're not already on our mailing list, I know some of you are, but I have one over here. If you want to send me your email, I'll let you know the next time we're back in town. Probably the next time we come back, we'll have a new CD with us, I think. So in the meantime, I have a whole plethora of them to keep you entertained. So. This is another song off of Sweetheart, and it is called The War. So thank you all for coming out tonight, and we'll see you next time. Off my sleeve and into my heart, I ask them to stay. Leave behind a little spark, because sometimes you need some help out of the dark.
Time, just pretend I walked to the bus and came back. And so, now he just, and he does Whiskey River again.
Whiskey
I've seen
River?
Him a couple of times, and he plays Whiskey River 3 or 4 times during the show.
Really?
Yeah, like he'll play some new songs that no one's heard, and everybody's kind of lulled.
Oh, what are the new songs?
And then he just goes, Whiskey River, take my mind. And it's just like, hats come off, people like,
yeehaw!
Yeah, beer goes flying, it's awesome. He's a smart man, he's been doing it a while.
It's... All right. I hope I remember all the words of this song, but we were practicing this in the back of the case on harmonica. And if I don't, you probably remember them.
No, I can do just a few.
You can do Roy Orbison's part.
I'll do Roy's part. I'll try.
This is a Traveling Wilburys song. I don't know if you guys know who they are, but...
Hey, jump up here.
It's a fun one.
All right, here we go.
It's called Handle With Care.